Like to go through a very small subject about the usage of surge arresters. Applicable to the countries in India and nearby countries. This may not be applicable for some other countries. So whenever we design lightning protection system, we should always keep certain rules. The rule number one is the conductors which is used for making a connection. Let us say, for example, you have a building and a lightning protection system which we are going to install. The conductor length has to be as short as possible, because if you use a more long conductor, due to the higher rate of change of current, dA by dt, more voltage drops and the chance of a higher potential difference exists. So the length of the wire shall be as short as possible. That means don't route it through unnecessary parts. You take it. The second point is you make it as straight as possible. Avoid bends. Even if you make a bend, there are certain rules, because if you make a sharp bend, there will during a lightning current flow, there will be mechanical forces, and the mechanical forces are going to create a trouble in the installation. The third one, the joints. Every joint made in a conductor shall be, as good as possible. Otherwise, there will be resistive heating, and the problems related to the resistive heating will destroy the whole installation. Then, especially in India nowadays, a lot of people ask us, I have a tall building and I wanted to put an insulated conductor, and the people think that using an insulator conductor, the lightning current will be flowing through a designated route. So you put, let us say, a 10 floor building, 35 meters, 40 meters height building. By putting few down conductors through electrical shaft and other shaft, people think that lightning current will flow through the insulated conductor. Unfortunately, this is not true. Only for short distance, maybe 3 meter, 5 meter, it may work. But for longer distances, the down conductor routing through specific routes will not work out. You have to create a very good equipotential system. And the last point is the touch and the step potential. The whenever the lightning current is dissipated, the touch and step potential shall be taken care very well. When we talk about the low voltage SPD, is a low voltage surge protection device, one of the parameter which we always discuss is called as the ultimate protection level or effective protection level. The voltage protection level of an SPD is a very important factor which decides the ultimate protection. Now what I am showing in this picture, I don't know whether you can see that. Yes, you can see the cursor. So I have put a surge arrester here, the point A, probably this is a line conductor, and B may be a neutral or an earth conductor. I have an SPD connected in parallel to the line, and line A and B. Now I have a longer wire here. Then I have a D. D stands for a disconnector. Probably this is a fuse, for example. Then I have an SPD, and then I have another line. The meaning of the ultimate or the effective protection level is the complete protection offered by the SPD, including the connecting wires. Connecting wires L1, connecting wire L2, plus there is a little bit length of the disconnecting device. The ultimate protection level, UPF, is... you have UP, protection level of the SPD. Let us say your target is to get a protection level of, let us say, less than 1.5 kV. Now, if you use an SPD of 1.2 kV protection level, low voltage, this is actually, I'm explaining about low voltage, then I go to the high voltage for convenience, because I'm sure a lot of people knows about low voltage SPD. So imagine you are using an SPD of 1.2 kV, then you use a longer wire. If the length of the wire is much longer, there will be higher voltage drop in the line. As a result, the effective protection which goes into your equipment will be much higher. As a result, you lose protection. So longer the wire length, the effective protection which is going into the equipment is shorter, or the effective protection level going into the equipment is also higher. So always the target is to use a very short wire. As a result of, you know, reducing the length of the connecting wire, busbar mounted SPDs had come up in the low voltage system. Busbar mounted SPD, there is no connecting length. The SPD is directly mounted on the busbar. So that means there are two kind of SPDs. One is the DIN rail mounted SPD and the next one is a busbar mounted SPD. A DIN rail mounted SPD, now I am showing a VI characteristics, ultimate protection level. With respect to the surge current, 10 kiloampere, 20, 30, 40, and 50 kiloampere, and the actual protection level, including the wire length. This one, the here at the bottom is the busbar mounted SPD, and on the top is the DIN rail mounted SPD. Say for example, the DIN rail mounted busbar mounted SPD at 20 kiloampere surge, the clamping, the overall protection which goes into the equipment is about 1.25 kV, and with a DIN rail mounted SPD it's about 8 kV. This is for a typical surge of about 20 kiloampere, and I considered a length of something about 500 to 600 mm, not more than that. Then for a 40 kiloampere surge, the clamping voltage of a DIN rail mounted SPD is about 15 kV. So here the problem is most of this additional voltage is due to the wire length. And the standard, the SPD installation standard, low voltage, it is very well explaining that the length of here you can see an SPD. Here is the point A and the point B. You have the wire length A, then you have the OCPD is nothing but the fuse, then you have the length B and then the length C. The total length of the connecting wire A plus B plus C shall be lesser than 0.5 meter. This is a mandatory requirement when you use a low voltage surge arrester. Similarly, when you go to a high voltage surge arrester, the IEC standard recommend you know, three kind of connections. There is a comparison given in the standard. The first one, you have the overhead line. You have a line L2 connecting to the surge arrester. Then you have the gapless surge arrester. Then you have from the surge arrester, from the earth wire of the surge arrester, earth terminal of the surge arrester, you have a longer wire to the earthing system. This is the one way of connecting the transformer and the body earthing of the transformer. You have a separate connection. Now, this is considered to be a poor connection because the loop which is created here, the loop L2 plus L3, the wire length is much higher. As a result, higher voltage goes into your transformer and you get lesser protection. The second way, which is the second connection which is shown here. Sorry, I think I also made some small mistake in the presentation. The second, the very good connection which is recommended in the standard is you are supposed to connect the surge arrester across the terminals of the device to be protected. Let us say you have a transformer. The best way is to connect the surge arrester very closer to the transformer between the terminals to be protected. Here, the surge arrester is limiting the transient overvoltage to a very low level. As a result, the insulation degradation or the insulation of the transformer is never stressed. This is the best protection which is recommended in the IS as well as the IEC standards. Similarly, in the IEEE standard, you can see the same IEEE 142. You can see the similar recommendation. You have the transformer body, and the line comes. Here, the surge arrester is directly mounted on the transformer body. So these are some of the recommendations which is there in the IEC and the IEEE standard. Now, the standards are also giving why you should reduce the line length. For example, IEEE 142, you can look at the clause number 5.2.5.5.2 and the other one 5.2.5.5.4. Then again, with examples, the phenomena is explained, and it very clearly says if you increase the length of the wire, then the stress which is going, the voltage stress, the transient voltage stress which is going into your equipment is higher. As a result, the chance of degradation of the insulation is higher, and you will end up with trouble. Now, this is a typical installation which is installed in India. Say, for example, you have a surge arrester. This is an indoor panel. You have a surge arrester, and this the bus bar, the aluminium bus bar. This is the earth bus bar of the surge arrester. You can see that you will be interested to see that this earth bus bar is an insulated one. It is insulated from the other metallic parts of this panel board. Now, through a rubber bushing, the earth wire is going out. This is the rubber bushing. So the manufacturer had ensured that you look, there is an earth bus bar, and the earth bus bar, without touching anywhere, it is going out. And once when it goes out, you can see here the earthing wire is taken through insulated conductor, and then it goes to this particular earth pit. And the insulated conductor, as I said, the rule, the connection shall be straight, the connection shall not have bend. All these are not taken care. Now finally, it is connected to an earth pit. This is the earth pit where the connection is made. Now if we calculate the length of the wire from this point to the earth pit, up to the earth pit, this is probably 7-8 meters. It is larger, longer. Say for example, I live in a building in Chennai, and in my building there is an indoor transformer. The 11 kV system is indoor, and in the transformer there is a surge arrestor, and the length of that earth wire, it is about 22 meters. 22 meters in the sense the length of the wire is about 22 meters. It is actually totally violating the requirements of the standard. This is a case of indoor substation, and in case of outdoor, you can see here there are three surge arrestors, and the surge arrestor earth wire is running down through the structure. And here you can see the insulator at this point is the earth wire is insulated from the structure, and this particular earth wire, it goes into the earth pit. Basically, in most of the cases, it is going to a separate earth pit, and the separate earth pit is connected to the earth mat or earth grid of typical substation. And in general case, the length of this earth wire is in several meters. And you should understand that if we go as per the calculation of the standard, a 5-meter lead length will create a potential drop of about 50 kV. There will be additional 50 kV stress, voltage stress into your transformer. As a result, the failure, the chance of failure of the transformer is higher. This is actually happening mostly in the distribution side, 11 kV, 22 and 33 kV transformers. Often the wire length is about 10 meter or more. Now, you can be very sure that in these cases, if the wire length is 10 meter or more, the lightning arresters will not work. It will not give any protection to your equipment. So the recommended practices in the standard, this kind of a connection is a poor connection. And the best connection is this one, the third connection. This is the best recommended connection. So always when you use a surge arrester in a line, please be sure, make sure that the line length are made to a very short level, and very short lines are used in order to get very good protection. So by this, I would like to stop.